Richard Southern joins us now from the 680 News Business Center. And Richard, is the cost of buying a home in Toronto still climbing?
It's actually climbed the most in 21 months. Question for you, Melissa. I'm going to pop quiz here. What the average selling price of a home last month? We're not talking detached, just the average selling price. Any guesses? Don't look at the bottom of the screen.
Okay, I won't look. I didn't look. I'm not cheating, I swear. $750,000?
No. We're above $900,000 now, Melissa. $913,000.
Okay, now I'm going to look.
Yeah, it's tough. That's the average selling price. If you want a detached home, it's going for just over $1.3 million, as we say. Prices in September jumping the most in 21 months. Condos not really that much better. The average condo selling price above $636K. Low interest rates, lots of demand driving it. Could also be speculation. Melissa, we found out that 66,000 homes across the city are sitting empty. So a lot of people continuing to buy properties as an investment. And get this one, the average selling price in Manhattan, real estate capital of the world, dipping just below $1 million. So it's pretty close to what we're seeing here in Toronto to the selling prices in the Big Apple, Melissa.
Almost on par with that. That's wild.
Crazy.
Now, it's a story we've been covering for the past little while, an impeachment inquiry into U.S. President Donald Trump, and it's all because of a whistleblower.
So the question is, would you blow the whistle on someone at work if you saw any wrongdoing?
Well, I'm looking around the newsroom.
Don't look
right
at me. Please don't look at me. We're friends, right? 94% of Canadians, though, said, yeah, they would blow the whistle if they saw some wrongdoing. That's pretty good, right?
Yeah.
40% say they have witnessed some form of wrongdoing in the workplace, and 77% of those said they were likely to report it. This whistleblower survey found that 96% of Canadians feel there should be lots of protections in place at the office for anyone who does come forward to report this sort of stuff. So it looks like we're pretty honest, and we want to make sure everything's on the up and up here.
It also makes me feel like we should be on our best behavior at all times.
Yeah, you never know who's lurking around the corner. You know, Mark McAllister's might have a keen eye on you.
He's
be careful
right
now.
Over there.
Okay.
Now, Uber users in New York, they have a new option that helps them rise above the city's traffic troubles.
And we're going to show it to you. It's a helicopter service. It's actually up and running. Ubercopter. It's only in Manhattan, though. What it does, it takes you from lower Manhattan to JFK. It's an eight-minute ride. It's cost $200 per person U.S., so it's expensive. But, you know, if you've ever tried to get from downtown Manhattan to JFK, you know, especially during rush hour, takes an awful long time. So this might be worth it to some people. They say this is just the beginning, though. They're really eyeing what we're looking at here, and that's kind of an electronic drone air service. Uber hopes to start testing this in the coming year. So look out, Melissa. Your Uber might be flying overhead before you know it.
Convenience at a price.
Yes, indeed.
And last but not least, Richard, you've got an update on some gas prices and some of the other stories you're tracking for 6.
Well, the good news is that the price of gas is set to drop a penny at midnight tonight. And coming up just after 6:30, we're looking at the push to have you using your cell phone on the TTC subway. We could see it, and we'll have all the details coming up.
Thanks, Richard. We'll talk to you a little later in the show.
Thank you.